action a little bit up to the finished the spherical lens.
Okay.
We use the spherical lenses to reduce optical errors in the optical system. And another big advantage from the spherical lenses is that we can use fewer lenses and design the compacter lenses. And so that means that we have less weight. The production line get lens as the pressed glass blank, as you can see in the front. And in the first step, the blank get grinded with a special diamond grinding tool. You can see there, yeah? And it grinds the spherical shape. The second step is the polishing the spherical shape with another polishing tool. This polishing tool has exactly the same radius like the spherical shape we need in the finished lens. After that step, we go to the spherical side. And for this, we glue the lens, the polished lens, on a mandrel, then we can use it on CNC machines. And this looks like this.
This mandrel.
Thank you. The spherical side of the lens is also get grinded with a diamond tool, like the spherical before. Yes, but not with the whole tool, but only with a small point of the tool. You get only with a small point of the tool over the whole lens. That's the reason why we need a lot of time, sometimes up to 40 minutes, for only this one shape. After grinding the shape, we polish the shape again, also with a smaller tool, much smaller tool. And here we need also something about 40 minutes. After the step, the lens has a deviation form that does not exceed 1 to 2 micrometers. But this is not good enough for us, and that's why we use another machine, which my colleague Dr. Stankovich will show you in a few minutes. You can see the whole production line to finish this spherical side. When the spherical side is finished, we take the lens off the mandrel again and finish the spherical side again with a polishing tool. And then you have the finished lens, which goes to the next production step. And then Mr. Stankovich is coming here.
Now we will enter the optics manufacturing department. It's a bit loud, but it's real. So people are working here. Please follow.
Enjoy. Thank you.
Perfect shape of about 200-300 nanometers, but it's not good enough yet. So it's measured on that tool over there, that's an interferometer, and the lens is compared to a perfect lens. The perfect lens is encoded in a hologram. We get a different signal, so we determine how big are the deviations from the perfect shape. And this signal is fed into this machine. This is a correction polishing machine. So this machine exactly corrects the lens on individual spots so that the lens gets the perfect shape. Afterwards, it has a deviation of about 100 nanometers, worst case, peak to valley, and a roughness of 10 nanometers. At this point, it's good enough. So this step, the last step before the lens is good enough, takes about 1 hour. 1 hour per lens. So it's quite a significant effort to reach this quality. Now these lenses are assembled together with a mechanical part in the assembly department, which will be one of your next spots. What we also do in the optical department here, we have the whole chain to produce lenses from the beginning till the end. We have anti-reflective coatings that we put on them, like you know from your glasses. We also paint the outer part of the lens black, so that you don't get unintended reflections within the objective. That's a highly manual step. And you will see this also on a later spot of the tour. So thank you very much, and I wish you a good day, and I will bring you to the next spot.
Please follow me.